Yeah, I think earlier also we were live. I don't know. Maybe some technical glitch. No problem. No worries.
Yeah, maybe. Yes.
Yes, we are now.
Sure. Okay. Yeah, we are live. Okay. I would start the session again. Hello, everyone. Welcome. Good afternoon, and hope everyone is safe and at home with their families. And we are really sorry we were a little late, actually. It was due to a technical glitch, and we will start our session now. So we are in association with Stratefix and Agrawal Yuwa Samaj today. And we thank them a lot for circulating the news in the city that we are doing these seminar in the times of pandemic and 21 days quarantine, so that everybody stays connected overall. And we thank CA Gaurav Singhvi. Extremely thankful to you, sir, ke aap itni short notice pe on board aaye. So please say something about yourself and what you do.
Thank you for inviting. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Gaurav Singhvi. I'm chartered accountant by profession. Choice. I invest in startups. That's what I do. I love to meet startups, you know, listen to their story. And that's what I do.
Okay. Sir, ये हमारा actually fourth session है. We have done three more sessions before. इससे पहले हमने session दिया था regarding business sustainability in quarantine, and before that working from home for startups during quarantine. And in this session we are majorly going to discuss about the government policies and what steps government are taking for growth of startups and businesses during this phase of quarantine as well as pandemic, right? So, sir, अगर हम इस बार के budget की बात करें तो it was specifically inclined towards startups and businesses, and बहुत सारे benefits थे जो हमारे budget ने offer किए थे इस बार. Would you like to say something about those benefits and describe the few important ones?
So, primary one is that government has put a lot of thrust on startup. They could realize that you know, if they wanted to go to $5 trillion economy, they have to really bring startup in the mainstream. You know, earlier they were thinking that startups are slowly gradually growing, but now they have identified and they have given that kind of a due recognition to startups. They have allocated a sizable amount of fund also for startups. There are a few more steps which government has taken, like considering the large corporates, you know, CSR fund can be invested as there for the engineering innovation and those kind of things, and it can be invested also. So that steps been taken. There are some steps which a government has taken for removing the anomaly money which was available in the ESOPs things and other things. So government has on level best to make sure. I think government is also evolving with the startups, because in India startup is relatively not a very old. The government thrust is from last almost about 5-6 years, and they are now they are also learning with the time that what all concessions to startups and what are their needs, what are their requirements. But in Startup India overall, the work which is being happening is a good work, and I think you know, if more people are interested to being startup, they can take a lot of benefits can be taken. Like there are some income tax benefits are also there if you are a company which is making profit, and consecutively 3 years, you can out of 7 years, you can take the benefit of tax, you know, tax which you can be having a profit without paying the tax and all.
Yes.
Yeah.
So current relaxations
if you, government standpoint, but I think a lot of things will come. Mm-hmm.
करंट जो अभी वक्त चल रहा है इट इज़ वेरी क्रूशियल बिकॉज स्टार्टअप्स लाइक इफ वी गो टू सी द यूनिकॉर्न स्टार्टअप्स ऑल्सो करंटली देयर वर्किंग आर गॉन बैक टू निल राइट बिकॉज अगर हम देखें तो बिग बास्केट जोमैटो स्विगी वो जो सारे स्टार्टअप्स हैं दे आर करंटली शट डाउन बिकॉज इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल टू ऑपरेट ड्यूरिंग दीज टाइम्स उन स्टार्टअप्स के लिए क्या रिलैक्सेशंस गवर्नमेंट फोर्सी कर सकते हैं आफ्टर दिस पैंडेमिक इज ओवर, स्पेशली द दोज वर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द सॉरी सर.
I tell you a very interesting fact. Apart from these delivery startups, which are into delivery space, maybe Zomato, Swiggy's, rest all are getting amazing response. Amazing response. Mm-hmm. Because this is the time of a technology. People are spending a lot of time on technology. So startups, those who are not delivery dependent or on entertainment dependent, like Make My Trip has a serious halt because nobody is traveling right now, no hotel being there. But if you see at large, no countries left, no businesses are left which are not affected by it. So it's not a problem only which is faced by a startup. It's a more of a problem which is a global problem. So I think, you know, all startups also, because they are also part of the mainstream businesses, so they can't be left behind. They can't be, you know, just kept nice. There are some startups, those who are just burning their cash. They have just, you know, they are spending more. Certainly they have a challenge because they have a fixed cost. They have a lot of fixed cost in terms of a lot of other budgets and other things. But apart from that, it's a right time because what you can understand monetization, what has happened in India, the digital currency has become prominent in India. Before that, if you see, people were not too much into using the digital currencies. But what has happened after, I think digital uses of content, online learning, you know, those kind of things, software things and other things, you know, lot things will be in utilization. There'll be so much of, you know, online meeting because people have realized and people are taking that kind of a learning curve for themselves, learning new technologies. So if you see, I'm seeing a very different situation. I'm seeing a better time for startups in after 15th of April or maybe 1st of May. I'm seeing a much better time, better acceptability for startups. So I have a very different opinion, a huge, huge upside for startups in coming times after 1st of May.
I agree with you, sir. Recently, Kunal Shah ne bhi ek tweet kiya tha, jisme bola tha that way the businesses operate is going to have an unchangeable effect now because everybody will realize that work from home is possible and can be equally effective. So yeah, it is completely agreeable. Uske alawa,
India was not accepting that. India was for a very long period of time was not accepting.
Yes. Overall, India mein the culture from work from home, the kal hi hamari session mein baat hui ki SOPs pehle Indian companies mein SOPs for remotely working were not developed. It was suddenly during this 21 days lockdown, suddenly everybody developed the policy and everybody is operational. At least the tech-based companies are definitely operational and doing well. Sir, CSR funds ki jo baat hui, how is the corporate response?
We are doing work. We are not a tech-based company, but we are.
So
it's a mixed response. Yeah, if you see that it's a mixed response, those who have initiated for it, but eventually there'll be an impact because it's a new thing for India. People are also evaluating that how can they go forward for this? How can they really utilize these kind of funds and what will be the right place to utilize this? So people are the corporate option. I would not. Yeah, certainly corporates have welcomed it because it is in their benefit that they can invest the money in innovation, in more of a, you know, product creation or something new. They want. Or certainly that's a good idea and a great idea for a bigger corporate. But I think it will take its own time. It will take its own time. Corporate community, the large corporate community will accept it totally and will understand. More important is how best they can understand that they can utilize the funds.
When it comes to funding, sir, there are a lot of startups who are being operated by students or say engineering students or CA students that are still studying and pursuing their business idea. So for those students, hum kya suggest kar sakte hai that for initial development of their business, if the funds are required, obviously. So for that, government is supporting in what ways and kahan ja sakte hai wo help ke liye for specifically for seed funding?
So there are a lot of incubation centers which are there. And apart from that, government Government of India, Startup India has placed, and then a lot of other organizations. You know, like there are a lot of angel networks which are there, and in there are early stage funds also. So I don't think capital is an issue. Capital is not at all an issue. If you are addressing a right problem, if your problem is well identified, and the problem which you are solving is solving for a larger market. You know, if your problem which you are solving is for a larger people, certainly there is a lot of money which is available. Capital is right now not a problem for startups, and we have seen, because I invest in startups, so I know that good startups are in the position of negotiating even at the age, at the stage of their idea stage or at a prototype stage. They are into a negotiating, that they are negotiating term sheets, they are getting and better valuations because of that. So how well you are, how best you are using your contacts or your content for presenting your idea, and what kind of data validation you have done for presenting that entire pitch that you will be doing this, and there are data points which are endorsing that what you are saying is right and what you wanted to do is right. So that's what is there. So I don't see capital as a problem, and I think if people wanted to really approach, they can approach multiple people. A lot of people are there who can be there, and now in the social media space, you can find mentors and number of people who are funding startups. CDB directly don't fund, but they AIFs early in the early stage also. Earlier there were no much of alternative investment funds were there, but now a lot of funding startups. We have recently launched an AIF called 9 Unicorn, which is just focusing on an ideas. So people can reach out to multiple people, multiple places they can go.
Okay, sir. So hamare viewers ko, I would like to request that you can post your questions in the window below, and we'll definitely try to address them. So Anil Parekh is trying to ask that, can you share some genuine and reliable venture capitalists to whom we can approach for funding? Sir, that depends on at what stage.
There are multiple people. I would not like to take the name of somebody. Mm-hmm. I would not like to take any name because that's not right. But, I think there are so many, and everybody is dependable. They don't feel that, people, money given by some investor, you can't consider them that they are not dependable. Everyone who's giving a money and putting up a risk money is a dependable person. I think their orientation in what kind of a sector they wanted to invest and what kind of a startup they are looking for, I think that's the more important. Do a little more research on a Google or by LinkedIn if you will like to find out. I think you can very well reach out to certain fund. We have our own network which funds, and we have our own fund. So it will not be right from my side to take anybody's name because a few others will feel offended that I am not taking their names. So I will not like to do that.
And sure, you can approach, sir.
We are called Venture Catalyst. We have AIF called 9 Unicorns. Yeah, certainly you can. I'm always available.
So Nitin wants to ask that how to start a business in this time and cover people, engage people, in social media. I guess, Nitin, I don't think this is a relevant question for sir, because regarding social media, I don't think he's the right person to ask. But any views, sir? Hello.
For me, your audience, whatever your audience is, I don't know who's your audience. Lots of people are spending so much of time on screen. Hello.
Yeah.
Are you getting my?
Yes, you are audible now.
Am I audible?
Now you are audible, sir.
Yeah. So what I'm saying, what's your target audience? Yeah, yeah. So what's your target audience? But this 21 days, you can't waste. Because the can't waste because, you know, this is the time when people will, are going to be more on screens. So the screen time of entire India, the level. And, you know, this is the time you have to capture your target audience. I don't know about your product. I don't know what's your TG. What is your target audience? Please identify that. Talk to your social media expert and engage your target audience. And this is the right time to reach out to your target audience.
Well said, sir. Sir, Sunny wants to ask that, can you please throw some light on iSafe notes?
iSafe notes.
What's that? Sunny, will you please be able to elaborate in the comments? What do you mean by iSafe notes and what is the exact detail you would like to know? We will move forward with the another question till then. So, Faith wants to ask that, according to your experience as you are investing in startups, which startup will work more after COVID situation, after the quarantine period ends? The question was, konse startup mein... Yeah. Can you hear me now? Are we audible? Can we please... Can someone please type in the comment section that we are audible or not? Okay. So Faith Punjabi wants to ask that ye quarantine period or if once this phase is gone, after that, kaun se startups boom dekhenge and which investment in which kind of startups will be recommended?
Depend karta hai. You can't just analyze it right now that which startups will be there, but you know, I think those startups, those who are in the online space, those not are in delivery, have a much better time, and they can really expand you know, because those who are operated, or you need not to have a delivery for something. I think that's a startup. And in general, I'm of the opinion that after 1st of May, you know, lots and lots of startup is going to be benefited out of it, because people are realizing that they have to go for a lot of change of technologies, a lot of innovations. In medical, there's going to be a huge, huge pumping of money everywhere in the across world, in the medical health sector. And, for all kinds of meditech, because entire West is totally helpless, in need of, entirely revamping the entire, health system now.
Also, the techno-based startups are also going to be very much banned, because remote from home, work from home, unattachable, matlab detach nahi kar payenge. It will be a regular part of our lives now, I believe. So the technology is relating to communication and the connection for businesses is going to be in boom overall. Okay. Akansha Singh wants to ask that, what do you see in startup before investing in it?
I think that somebody was asking about. So I go by, I go by a founder.
Okay.
For me, the most important person is a founder, because idea worth $10 only. How powerful the founder is, what kind of an executional capability. So, I give, major weightage to a founder, that how capable that person solving, and third, what kind of an understanding he has about solving that problem. So there are three stages which I go for. And I think there was somebody who was asking about India Simple Agreements. I said,
right.
I think he was somebody was asking about that. I think you know.
And Sunny was, I guess, asking for the same.
Recently introduced option, which is there, where you invest in. Recently introduced, you know, way by which you invest in a startup in a cash, and then eventually it gets converted. There, that, you know, it has their own future because these are new latest, you know, a lot of startup doesn't have a pre-decided valuations. So in that space, a lot of people are using that now. Why it's not widely, you know, available in India earlier, but now a lot of people are
using this. Okay, sir. So Mr. Hiren wants to ask, sir, that abhi jo scenario chal raha hai, the e-commerce company specifically.
There is no interest because they are not that. They are just convertible note which is invested. Yeah.
Yeah, so in the e-commerce sector,
I can't listen to you.
Yeah, can you hear me now? Am I audible? I think there is a little time lag. Okay. I guess there was a connection issue. We'll try to get back, sir, online. Just we can wait for a while till he reconnects. Will you try to reconnect? Because he has gone offline. There was a connection issue. Yeah, we are trying to reconnect and sort out the little technical glitch that happened. Please hold on for a while. Yes, yes, there was some. Okay, yeah, I think we are online again. I will take a few more questions now. This one is from a e-commerce company. They are saying that it is going to take at least 2 to 3 months now for them to get back on track. So in this time, what will be your suggestions for cutting down operational cost or surviving through them? Any suggestions for them, sir?
So I think the moment COVID-19 has started, you know, the first hit was to the startups, and everyone in the world was saying that, you know, now all startup has to think about their, unit economics. They have to unit economics positive. Is their unit economics making sense for they being in the business? or they are just burning the cash and just to acquire new customers. So I think this is the right time when you have to identify that what's more important for you. And as an e-commerce, you have to really go for major cost cuts, major cost you have to go for. And you have to identify that whatever you are doing, you know, how logical it is to do and what kind of a funding options. Because now I see there's going to be a little more tougher screening, which individual startups or sorry, investors will also do and funds will also do. So I think the logic is very clear that you need to cut a lot of costs, especially manpower cost, any kind of a manpower cost which you have, hired, or any other cost which I think probably I'm not aware about your cost element, what all cost you have incurred. But if you have incurred any kind of a cost which is not making any sense or which is not generating any kind of a productive revenue for you, you will have to really cut down on that. It's a very important thing right now. You have to operate with a lean,
yes, sir.
Productive employee setup team.
Absolutely. So Neeraj ji wants to know that a startup means a business has to be digital based, or any MSME can be a startup.
No.
And MSME can be a startup, what are an example?
So there can be, like, we have invested in Beardo. Beardo has nothing to do with digital. You know, I have invested in Beardo, P-Safe for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
Fire, we have invested, and these are all non-tech based startups. I have in my portfolio of 50, I have invested in 54 companies up till now. And in my portfolio, there are almost about 16 or 17 companies which has nothing to do with technology. They are purely product companies. So if you are doing
product based,
suddenly they are product based companies. So there's absolutely no necessity of that, and they are doing phenomenally good. They are doing.
So next question is that there is any specific industry or geographical focus that you consider while funding startups?
No, certainly not. No geography, no sector. We are open to all kind of this. We are sector agnostic. So we are absolutely not looking at that. We invest in all sectors, every sector. So any kind of sector is most welcome.
Okay, sir. I thought the time is pressing, but this one last question, that being from this industry and being around here for a while now, what would you suggest, or what will your opinion be regarding any guidance or any suggestion that we can give formation of new policies for startups and businesses overall to get through the COVID situation, as well as in future to help them grow? हम क्या सजेस्ट या कर सकते हैं? What kind of policies shall be implemented to take it further?
Check your unit economics. Don't burn the money just to get the get the traction. That's not the right way to build, and people have learned it. All the startups have learned that your unit economics has to be right, and that's the startup are going to be doing. And second, you need not to be only a copy startup. Don't be in a copy startup. Have your own exclusive mode, something extraordinary which you are doing, or some extraordinary offering which you are doing. You may be different by a distribution, you may be different by a technology, you may be different different by a customer experience. You can be different by anything, but you have to be different. You have to be different from another startup, and you have to really be clearly be differentiator in that term. So I think have a right unit economics. And second is you need to have a right kind of a, moat or something offer, which others are not offering, or the same competitors in which you are, you stand out by one of the activity. It can be anything. It can be anything, which differentiates you.
I would give an example of Ola, actually. It is actually something that Uber did in US that we brought in India, but Ola's tech and customer experience has been really nice till now. If we talk about the being different than what others are already doing, I believe.
Hello.
Yeah. So, so any expectation that we can keep from government or any suggestion that you would like to give the policy makers about this? That hume ye expectation hai as a startup or business?
I think they should know. So there are a lot of expectations. This is not the right forum where I need to share that, because I think government is listening. But I think they should take up a lot of new people from startup sector to advise them. I think the people, those who are advising, are not investing, and they are making the policies from their own logic, from their own understanding, from the other country's view, which is not the right way to do it. I think they should be taking more feedback from the people, those who are investing, or the funds, or the successful startup founders, those who are there. There are certain unicorns. There are almost about 37 unicorns in India which has made, and I think out of that, if they take help of few people in the formation of a startup policy, that would be a more logical thing.
Absolutely. So that is agreeable. So regarding further questions, I would like to tell our viewers that we will definitely try to answer you via Facebook comments. For now, we'll have to bid adieu to sir. And it has been a great session, sir. Thank you. Thank you for joining us here. And we would like to close this session with thanks to our partners, Stratefix and Agrawal Yuwa Samaj. And please join us for our next session tomorrow. Thank you. Yeah. We would go offline, sir. Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.